The railway company whose train caused a fiery crash denies allegations that his company has a spotty safety record. The Canadian Broadcasting Corporation says Railworld Inc. had 8 derailments and 10 spills since 2009. However, the company president says those have all been small incidents. So, are Maine officials ready for such a disaster if one were to happen here? And that is the question we posed to several agencies today. WMTW News 8's Jim Keithley has more in our continuing coverage tonight, live from Portland. Jim?
Well, Tracy, we're just down from Woodford's Corner, considered one of the busiest intersections in the city of Portland. You can see railroad tracks run right through here with nearby homes on one side, businesses on the other, very close to these tracks. Now, freight trains carrying all kinds of cargo pass through here all of the time, and we wondered how much of that crude oil is on those trains. So much crude oil is passing through Maine, state agencies are looking at their maps and revisiting their disaster plans, especially in the wake of the tragic train explosion and fire in that small Quebec town that caused so many deaths and so much destruction. Some startling figures from the Maine Department of Environmental Protection. During the month of March, 870,000 barrels of crude oil passed through Maine by train, a dramatic increase from a year earlier when 55,000 barrels of crude oil rolled through the state during the same month. The DEP says only since November 2011 have trains from North Dakota started coming through Maine bound for Canada, accounting for the spike in the numbers. DEP officials say that they have 25 responders who are on call 24/7.
DEP responds to about 3,000 oil and hazmat spills annually, so our responders are busy, you know, 7 days a week, and from anything from a home heating oil spill to something like a train derailment.
The DEP says just a handful of those 3,000 incidents involve train derailments. The DEP says the Federal Rail Authority is the agency responsible for railroad track safety and inspections, but no one from that agency returned our calls to find out how often Maine tracks are inspected. Over at Maine's Emergency Management Agency, they too say they're ready to respond in the event of a disaster. The Emergency Operations Center in Augusta becomes a hub of activity. There are 19 hazmat teams throughout the state, trained and ready to go to whatever disaster calls.
If a specific kind of response is needed, you know, not just firefighting, but perhaps a hazardous materials response, we can bring the appropriate team in or elements of that team very quickly.
Now, to give you a sense of the collaborative effort involved in these emergency situations, South Portland Fire Department, for example, has a foam trailer, and they have that because of all of their oil tanks in that city. Well, they would be called in a derailment situation. So we learned that different cities, different towns have different pieces of equipment and different materials that can be used when called upon. We're live in Portland tonight. Jim Keithley, WMTW News 8.